Hey YouTubers, welcome to episode 4 of Baking with Billy. Today we will be ascending the Mount Everest of baking the cheesecake. The cheesecake is one of the oldest foods known to people and was developed over 2,000 years ago in Greece by the ancient Grecians, and soon after was picked up by New Yorkers, and that's why we have what today you're probably most familiar with, the New York style cheesecake. Some people like their cheesecake plain, some people like to put toppings on it. So toppings, you can put blueberries, strawberries, blackberries, raspberries, blueberries, pretty much any sort of berries, fruit, chocolate, caramel, peanuts. Toppings are limitless. But today we're just going to focus on the cheesecake itself and hopefully end up with that cheesy, cakey flavor that it's famous for. Cheesecakes are notoriously hard to bake, so just be sure to follow the instructions closely, watch along, and before long, you'll be baking a cheesecake like a pro. Alright, first ingredient we've got today is honey-made graham crackers. These are made with real honey. There's no high fructose corn syrup or anything bad in there. These are going to form the crust of the cheesecake, so they're going to be fun, like the bottom part of the cheesecake to kind of hold the cheese and the cake in there. Nutrition facts for you. We've got 130 calories, 3 grams fat, 0 grams trans fat, 0 milligrams cholesterol, 160 milligrams sodium, 24 grams carbohydrates, and 2 grams sugar. And it's mostly flour, a little bit of sugar. So you pick these up just about any grocery store. And again, this is the crust of the cheesecake, so the pie part. This will not be in the filling. First ingredient. Second ingredient today is cream cheese. This is Philadelphia brand. Pick it up just about any grocery store. This will be the main, some would argue, the main ingredient in cheesecake. We're actually going to need 3 packs of these. There's no preservatives, so it's just 5 ingredients. Nutrition facts. 100 calories, 10 grams of fat, 30 milligrams cholesterol, 110 milligrams sodium, less than 1 gram of carbs, and 2 grams of protein. Again, we're going to need 3 packs of these, and we want it to be room temperature when we use it, so leave it out a little bit before. Second ingredient, cream cheese. Third ingredient today is butter. You guys are probably familiar with butter. We use it in some other recipes. This is also going to be part of the crust. So what we'll be doing is melting the butter and mixing it with the graham crackers to form the crust. I don't have any nutrition facts on here, but you can look it up on the internet probably. It's just regular butter. This is sweet cream, unsalted butter. We're gonna need about half a stick of it. So third ingredient. Fourth ingredient today is eggs. I think we're gonna need 3 eggs, and so I bought 6. You can buy more or less, however. Just as usual, check to be sure they're not cracked. Nutrition facts, 70 calories in 1 egg, 5 grams of fat, 185 milligrams cholesterol, 70 milligrams sodium, 0 grams carbohydrates, and 8 grams protein. Pick them up just about any grocery store. Eggs are also going to be in the filling part. These will be mixed with the cream cheese in the middle part of the cheesecake. So, third ingredient. Fifth ingredient we've got today is sour cream. This is Daisy brand. It's white. You can pick it up just about any grocery store. Pure natural. And 2 tablespoons, we've got 60 calories, 5 grams fat, 20 milligrams cholesterol, 15 milligrams sodium, 1 gram carbs, and 1 gram protein. This will also be in the filling along with the eggs and the cream cheese. Just gives it a little bit of sour, creamy taste, and yeah, it's gonna be great. Fifth ingredient. Sixth ingredient we have today is sugar. It's just regular white sugar that you put on your table. This will also be part of the filling in the cheesecake. Nutrition facts, no fat, 0 cholesterol, 0 sodium, 8 grams sugar, and 0 grams protein. Pick it up just about any grocery store. This will add a little sweet flavor to the cheesecake. So, sixth ingredient, sugar. Okay, our final and last ingredient today is vanilla extract. This just adds a little bit of vanilla flavor to the cheesecake, doesn't do much else. You can pick this up just at any grocery store. We only need about 2 teaspoons of this, so you won't need a whole bottle. It comes in a little brown bottle. Final ingredient, vanilla. Okay, so first step we're gonna have today is a graham cracker crust. We're just gonna take a pack of graham crackers and we need to turn these into graham cracker crumbs. So we're just gonna take out some graham crackers and put them into a bag. And then we just have to crush them up into crumbs. So you can use your hands if you want. Or you can really just use anything you have laying around the house to crush them up. Spoon will work. Okay. Can opener. Just anything that can crush. So we're just gonna beat them up. Beat them up until you have a fine powder of graham cracker crumbs. And we need about 1 3/4 cups, so I might have to do this again in another bag. But once we have that ready, then we're ready to form the crust. Okay, so after we've crushed our graham cracker crumbs, we'll measure out 1 3/4 cup and put them into a bowl. We have here 1/3 cup of melted butter. You can melt it in the microwave, the stove, the oven, put it out under the sun, just any heat to melt the butter. And then we've got our sugar ready, and to add a little extra flavor, we're gonna do a little bit of cinnamon. So I'll put a little bit of cinnamon in there with the graham cracker crumbs, just a little sprinkle. And then we'll add our melted butter. And we'll measure out 1/4 cup of sugar. And now we're just going to mix that all together. Okay, and once that's done, it should be about the consistency of wet sand. So now we're ready to make the crust. Okay, so now we have our crust mixed and ready to go. And we have our springform pan. This is a special pan you use for cheesecakes. It helps just springform to the cake. And so we're going to use that. This is a 9-inch version. And before we put the crust in, we're just going to give it a spray down with some nonstick spray on the bottom and around the sides. Now we're just going to spoon the crust mix into the pan. And just spread it evenly along the bottom of the pan, the springform pan. And then we're just going to use a cup or anything you have with a flat bottom edge to press down the crust mixture into the bottom of the pan to make it nice and flat and smooth. Okay, so once that's nice and smooth and flat, it looks kind of like a graham cracker. Now we're just going to preheat our oven to 300 degrees Fahrenheit and pop this baby in the oven for about 10 minutes. That'll help it get nice and crisp before we put the filling in. So I'm gonna pop this in the oven now. Okay, so our next step, we're going to make the cake cheese part of the cheesecake. This is a filling that goes on top of the crust. So we've got our 3 packages of Philadelphia cream cheese. These have been sitting out for about an hour to let them get a little lukewarm and softened. So we're gonna dump those in the bowl. 1, 2, 3. And now we're going to add 1 cup of sugar. And now we just need to use our mixer to mix that up until it's nice and smooth. Okay, probably should have used a bigger bowl, but it'll be okay, as you can see. Okay, so now we're going to put our next ingredients in. Okay, our next ingredients, we have 1 container of sour cream, so going to dump that in there. And for our next ingredient, we have 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. Now we're going to mix this until it's nice and smooth. Okay, and now we will add our final ingredient, the eggs. So our last ingredient to add to the filling is our eggs. We'll be adding 3 eggs, and we will be adding them 1 at a time and only beat until it is mixed in. We don't want to over mix it. So, first egg. Again, don't overmix it. Second egg. And our final egg. Okay, and as you can see, the egg yolks gave it a nice creamy yellow color. That'll help it taste better. And so now we have our filling ready and our crust ready, and we're going to pour the filling into the crust. Okay, so now we have our crust, which has been baked for 10 minutes. I have a little more melted butter here, and we have our filling, which is nice and mixed up. And we're going to take a little more melted butter and our kitchen paintbrush and just put some butter around the edges so that the filling does not stick. Okay, and now we're going to pour the filling onto the crust. And we'll try to smooth that out a little bit. Okay, now she's ready to put in the oven. So our oven is set to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Now we're going to take our cheesecake and just pop it in. And now all we can do is wait for about 1 hour.
1 hour later.
Okay, it's been about 1 hour, a little over an hour. And so we're gonna crack this open and take a look. Oh yeah. Got some nice cracks going on. Those will be good for putting the toppings inside of. And you can see it's starting to get a little brown around the edges. And kind of hot, but a little jiggly in the middle. So I think this baby's done. So we're actually gonna let it cool down a little bit in the oven. So I'm gonna leave the oven cracked open, turn off the oven, and just let it sit in the warm oven for a little while to let it cool and finish baking. Okay, so we've got our cheesecake out. It's a little jiggly still. And it's about cooled down to room temperature. So now we're gonna take it and put it in the refrigerator to let it cool completely, get nice and cold and hard. So we're just gonna take it very carefully, put it inside the refrigerator, and we're just gonna let it sit there for about 4 hours inside the refrigerator.
Many unbearable hours later.
All right, so we have our cheesecake. It's been in the refrigerator about 4 hours now and is pretty solid. So we can go ahead and unbuckle the springform pan, lift up the sides. Oh yeah, so got a nice brown edge going around the side. And again, we've got this beautiful cracks on top. So now I'm just going to take a knife and cut me a slice. Now for the final step, the taste test. Two thumbs up. Well, that's all she wrote. Thanks guys for watching. I hope it was educational and that you learned how to do a cheesecake, and I hope your cheesecake turned out well, and just comment below if you liked it, if you don't like it. And thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe and just keep watching for more Baking with Billy. Thanks guys for watching.